9 years I've been the treasurer of the federation and the deputy secretary general, and now the last 3 years as the secretary general. And what I've learned was that there are three parts of the federation. One is the academic part, which we all, there is the conference which is, represents the academics of the our fraternity. Today we have got around 1500 registrations. We have had three workshops with 200 registrations yesterday. We have all three workshops, they are fantastic. And today we are having an ongoing academic program, and it's been a really big success as far as we are concerned. But this is the least relevant part of the federation. The second most important part of the federation is the fellowship part. We need to be friends with each other. When a patient comes to your clinic, and maybe the management has been different from your colleague has managed her differently, you must never badmouth her. This is very important. The fellowship and the integrity of the fraternity is very important, and that binds the federation together. So that's the second important part of an organization. But the third most important part of the organization is community service. And that is what we have to evolve towards. You know, we need to be more, you know, we file our income tax returns every year. The income tax commissioner says, oh, but what is the charity have you done? Why should we give you income tax exemption? And so more and more charity has been done by the federation. This year we have really peaked, and we have earmarked nearly $200,000 for charity. I mean, in dollar form, because some of you are here. Nearly 30-40 lakhs have been earmarked for the Nari Swasthya Payal program. And a lot of programs. You know, when I look back, I wish I could rewind my life by 20 years and do everything what I wanted to do. But well, time has passed by, and I hope that because I leave this post in one more month's time, and I hope that my next person who comes in, Tehzeeb Tang, who is sitting there, will continue what we have started, and Manyata is a part of it. So I feel that, you know, our fraternity is more academic oriented. I needed the fraternity to be pulled towards community service. But my dad, who was from Harvard University, was a Padma Shri, he was a master's in public health. He always told me that Rishikesh, be a doctor, a surgeon, because I wanted to be a community medicine person. He said, don't be a community, be a surgeon, be a gynecologist, and then at the end, veer towards community medicine, because that's how you can pull your colleagues into the community medicine fold. So this is the story till so far. I don't know what is in store for me for the next 20 years. But now coming to a better, more important part of my talk, I would like to introduce the chief guest of the day, Srimati Pankaja Munde. She is the Minister of Rural Development, Child and Family Welfare, Government of Maharashtra. Srimati Pankaja Munde is a second generation, down-to-earth, young and dynamic leader from the Bharatiya Janata Party. She served as the state president of BJP's youth wing, the Bharatiya Janata Yuva Morcha, in 2012. She was elected to the Legislative Assembly of Maharashtra from Parli constituency in 2009. She took oath as Maharashtra Cabinet Minister on 31st October 2014. She was allotted Ministry of Rural Development, Women and Child Welfare, and Water Conservation. So very important portfolios, actually. She is well known for the Pune Sangharsh Yatra in 2014 and work on female feticide prevention, improving laboratory facilities at district and rural hospitals, and encouraging women to participate in a number of social justice programs. She is a very dynamic leader, and a lot of things are in store for her. I wish I could exchange places with her. I'm very envious of your post. Please, I would like you to come onto the dais and share your views.
Friend conference and all the dignitaries on the dais, the president of FOCSI, my friend Rishma Bhai, the brand ambassador for Manyata, the very talented and very, you can say, health icon of the industry. Her introduction was too long, so I wouldn't take more long now. Shilpa Shetty, my friend Poonam Dhillon, who is always socially active and always there. She's been successful in industry, but she's a great friend, more than that. So that is why she's always loved by all of us. My other friend, Nandita Parshit, all dynasts are my friends somehow. All the dignitaries on the dais, all the doctors over here in the conference. I know we all are waiting for law. And as Shilpa Shetty said, that nobody seems delivering in Mumbai today, all the gynecs are here. So I don't want to prolong that calls you're getting from your clinic or your hospitals. But I am here as a Women and Child Welfare Minister, also as a Rural Development Minister. As a Rural Development Minister, all the primary healthcare centers and all the civil hospitals come under me, and I have to work on upgrading them. When I came up with this program and when I was called for this program, Honorable Nitinji Garikari also called me and he insisted that I should go, though Poonam and Rishma were calling me. But when he said that as a government you should be part of this program so that you can get some ideas to upgrade our healthcare system. Me, being a Women and Child Welfare Minister, take care of nutrition of women at the age of puberty, when they deliver and when they're feeding the baby, when they're pregnant. And also, I take care of the nutrition of the kids. I don't take care of the delivery part of it, it goes in health department. But being a rural development minister, all that infrastructure comes under me. When I was not a minister, I was working on Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao then. And also I worked on female feticide. I saw that female feticide was such a curse to our system, our country. And I worked on that and had huge rallies, I had all this participation from all over. And I realized, jo hame janam deti hai, hum uska janam na kaate. Hamare yahan believe hai, I don't know whether it is true or not, but we say ki ye srushti adi shakti ne banayi hai, ek stri ne banayi hai. And hum uska janam na kaate. At the same time, we call mother nature, but we don't let any mother get birth and take breath in this system and we stop it, that is also a curse. So we are working on that also. So when we upgrade these hospitals, when we upgrade these primary healthcare centers, all these clinics on the district level, on the taluka level, we also work on these kind of psychologies which work anti-social. So I'm sure Manyata will also work on that. In India, if we see infant mortality rate is so high, I'm sure we all spoke about mother mortality, but it's also infant mortality is India is 78%. In Maharashtra is better because Maharashtra is a very progressive state, but still 90% is an infant mortality rate. So imagine one mother dies, one life dies. We just saw the video. Ek maa nahi hoti to ek bachpan nahi hota. That bachche apne bachpan se bahut bahut vanchit ho jata hai. वैसे ही जब एक बच्चा मरता है, when there's infant mortality, एक माँ ही उसके साथ उसका भी एक बार मर जाता है. So we have to work on these both the things as a health issue. All these gynecologists are here and all the institutional delivery is happening. Now it is increasing day by day. We have to work on that also. Why 46,000 women die every year? Because they are not getting the facilities. They are not reaching the hospitals. We are talking about educating them, we are talking about training them, we are talking about giving them nutrition values and all these, but there are some people, there are some communities, there are some lives which are much far away from all this. I go to tribal areas where I talk about malnutrition. I see death of women, children and women because of malnutrition. So I think even in a normal life, we visit gynecologists only 3 times, in puberty, in delivery and in menopause. Not other than that, but it's beyond all that. So I think when we as government work on puberty level girls, because we want to make them a strong woman, we want to work on their womb should be strong to give a healthy, lead a healthy life and give birth to a healthy child, so that we have a healthy generation. So malnourishment can be fought by taking care of puberty girls and giving them right direction. So as you rightly said, when you walked, that walk you did? She matters. So I really like, and coincidentally I'm wearing the same color, so they all said, how did you do the theme. So I said, I am in government, so I have my intelligence. So I knew to wear what color to wear. But still, she really matters. Her life matters. बहुत सारी दुनिया में ऐसी घटनाएं घटती हैं जहाँ बच्चा पेट में जो है वो लड़की है, इसलिए उसको टाइम के बाद गिराया जाता है, उसके बाद उस मदर को भी अपनी उसमें जान गंवानी पड़ती है. तो उसकी जान की कीमत हमारे यहाँ कुछ भी नहीं है. सो ये एक बहुत अच्छी अवेयरनेस कैंपेन है. आई ऑटोमेटिकली बिकेम ब्रांड एम्बेसडर ऑफ श्री मैटर्स वेयरिंग दिस थीम. ऑल ऑफ यू, आई आई एम पार्ट ऑफ दिस थीम एंड आई कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट Foxy for coming up with Manyata. I thank Foxy President and Shilpa ji to be part of this, and I, as a part of government, as a minister, assure you that we will extend all the help and all the infrastructure and all the dais will be made available to all of you. And you don't only work with private nursing homes, you work with us with sub-district nursing homes, and mostly all the institutional deliveries of people you cannot afford private nursing home. There is huge number of people who cannot afford private treatments. So we can upgrade together. You being an NGO, you being a whole system, and we being government, we can join hands in that. So we surely meet for that, and maybe next program we'll be able to do some pilot work on that. And I will assure you that we will extend all the help. After, in spite of having freedom for 70 years, 7 decades, we're still fighting on mortality, infant mortality and mother mortality. It is not a good scenario, but still, the numbers decreasing is a good scenario. It gives a positive hope to me. So I always encourage this kind of work, and I feel all the celebrities are joining, all the doctors. You are all successful doctors, you are working on your level, you are quite successful, but you want to give back to society. So I really appreciate this cause and appreciate these efforts. I'm very happy to be part of this dais, and I always would like to work with you, no matter what it is. I will always be there working for that mother who gave us life, for that mother's life and that child's life, because that one life matters, she matters. Thank you so much.
Wonderful words. May I request Dr. Rishikesh Pai to present a token of appreciation to our chief guest. We really appreciate that you've taken time off your busy schedule to grace this occasion. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the important objectives of FOXI, as Dr. Rishikesh Pai said, is continuing medical education for its members. In keeping with this, this year FOXI has released 8 publications in the form of newsletters and FOXI focuses, all with the latest information.